amazing people, Brenda here, and welcome back to my channel. In the past like two videos, we've been talking about why you need to face your past and the ways that you can use so that you can heal from your past pains and past traumas. We are talking about the story of Joseph. Joseph was sold into slavery by his brothers, but later he was appointed to be the prime minister in Egypt. And when the brothers came looking for food, he had the perfect opportunity to revenge for what they had done to him. But instead, he chose to restore his broken relationship with the brothers instead of revenging. So today, we're going to talk about forgiveness. What is forgiveness? With me here, I have my two amazing friends.
Filda,
Mahaha,
and Barak.
Yeah, and this is Barak. So she has a channel by the name Filda Mahaha. You can go check her out.
Mighty everlasting Father, we come before you this time. Lord, as we learn about forgiveness, Lord, may you speak unto your children in a special way. We commit every viewer of this channel unto your hands. As we are going to speak, may you plant a seed in the listeners. For this I humbly pray, trusting and believing in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
With me is Barak. I'll let him begin.
Thank you. Hello, viewers. We are so humbled to have you stay tuned to our discussion this day, and we invite you to study with us from the Word of God to know what it entails. When we talk about forgiveness, it's a very hard topic to crack down, and it depends on how you view it. But there's God's way and God's ideal situation when it comes to forgiveness. For God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes should pay. In other words, we were supposed to die because the wages of sin was death. But forgiveness was wrought to us through the man Jesus Christ, who is our Lord and Savior, who is our Redeemer and also our Creator. So when we talk about forgiveness, we want to bring to our attention, why should somebody forgive? What prompts somebody to forgive? It means that this person who had experienced a bitterness from maybe friends, family members, or even relatives. They could have done something which is not appealing to this person. So in the process, he or she is grieved and wants to be appeased. And the only way that can happen is by him or her accepting that a wrong has been done, so that a process of forgiveness and healing can begin.
True.
Yeah, because the Bible, there's an account of this young man called Joseph. I believe that we all know who Joseph is. Who do you think Joseph is?
Joseph was the son to Jacob. Mm-hmm. Joseph was sold to Egypt as a slave. But through God's grace, he was promoted to a prime minister, imagine.
Wow. Yeah. So we will desire to look a little bit. What leads Joseph to this extreme end that he's even sold by his own brothers?
Sure.
To a foreign land. We consider the book of Genesis, we realize that Joseph had this character that was outstanding.
Mm-hmm.
And his character was like a constant rebuke to his brothers.
True.
Because he did not party with them in their wrongdoings.
Mm-hmm.
And because the father Jacob gave birth to Joseph at his old age, he loved him so much.
Very much.
So we see that what leads to his hatred from his brothers is parental partial love. He was loved more than other brothers.
Yeah.
That's why Jacob is coming up with a coat of many colors.
Yeah.
And because of this, they begin to say that why is he liked more than we are?
Yeah.
And this was a way of planting a seed of discord in the heart of the son. And because Joseph is pious, he loves Jesus, he loves God at that tender age, and he respects what his father Jacob is saying. He used to know who God is, and his desire was to commune with God and to do every perfect will of God.
All right.
And because of that, the Lord communed with him.
Wow.
The book of Psalms 25 verse 14 tells us something, that the secret of the Lord are with them that fear the Lord. And so the Lord reveals the secrets to him. If we can also make more sense, Daniel chapter 2 verse 28 says that, and there is a God in heaven who revealeth what?
Secrets.
And this only happened after they had sought the Lord at night in prayer.
Sure.
That means that those who seek the Lord in prayer are able to know the secret of who? Of the Lord. You could also be hated because of how you dispossess yourself and how you conduct yourself, in the sense that you will be a minister of the gospel who is zealous for the cause of God.
Amen.
And because you desire to walk faithfully with the Lord, some may take you as an extremist.
Sure.
You may be called names for the sake of your God. And now you may ask yourself, why am I going through this? When I'm a servant of God, I believe when they're taking Joseph and putting him in that ditch, Joseph is asking himself, why is all this happening? I believe I'm a man of God, I'm a servant of God, and I've done nothing wrong. If my brothers are doing something wrong, I believe my dad. And my dad is happy with me because I tell him what is happening. So why is God leaving him? And to make it even more worse, after being sold, he's in the house of Potiphar. God has given a favor with Potiphar. And all that was happening in the house of Potiphar, it was blessed because of who?
Joseph.
Now a time comes when Potiphar's wife loves Joseph because of his good character, because of his good conduct. He's landing in jail.
Mm-hmm.
And remember, there are two people who have been taken to jail because of their mistakes.
Mm-hmm.
They have dreams. Nobody was able to give the interpretation. But when Joseph comes, he's able to interpret and the dream comes true.
Mm-hmm.
The interpretation of these things comes true. And when this happens, we find out that the king restores one and one is killed.
Sure.
After many, many years in the cell, Joseph is rising out to a governor after interpreting the dream of the Lord.
The king.
And Pharaoh was moved with his wisdom, because his wisdom never came from man but from God.
Sure.
I'm sorry, we digress a little bit so that we could understand what was happening.
Mm-hmm.
Now, while he's in Egypt, what happens?
So we find out that after Joseph has been sold by the brothers, they later come to Egypt,
mm-hmm.
because in their land there was drought,
mm-hmm.
and so they had to seek for food. So they came to Egypt, and Gezu was in charge of the stores of Egypt.
You just said that there was drought in their land.
Yeah.
That means that they were struck with famine.
Sure.
So they lacked food.
Yeah.
All right. What happened in Egypt?
So they came to
mm-hmm.
Egypt,
mm-hmm.
Because God was with Joseph, he made Joseph in charge of the stores of food in Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
And so the brothers have to come and seek food from Egypt. Remember, these brothers, they sold Joseph to Egypt. And now they have to come and seek food from the same Joseph. He knew the brothers, but the brothers didn't know him. These are people who hurt Joseph. But because Joseph trusted in God, he had to overlook what they did to him.
Wow.
Yeah. That's forgiveness. Sometimes we may have deep scars in us, but because we know God, because we trust in God, and we have the character of Christ, Christ bore the shame, bore the sin that me and you committed. What a great forgiveness because of God.
Now that would actually bring us to the question, what is forgiveness in essence?
Forgiveness is letting go. That's my definition. All letting
right.
go what someone has done for you. With
I want to believe that forgiveness is the disposition to pardon.
Okay.
Being able and willing to pardon.
Okay.
It is the act of forgiving.
All right.
Now, when God forgave humanity through his son Jesus Christ, he pardons and remembers their sins no more.
Sure.
Yeah, he says that if we confess our sins,
he is faithful
and just to forgive. And also able to cleanse us from all what?
Our iniquities
or all unrighteousness. In
sure.
other words, it's upon us if to confess.
Mm-hmm.
It begins by me.
Yeah.
For me to be able to forgive a fellow friend, I need to accept that I've been wrong.
Yeah.
And for that wound to heal, I have to take it primitively,
sure.
as if I'm the one who did the mistake,
yeah.
and seek for my friend, that we may make peace.
Mm-hmm.
In that moment, I'll be freed of the burden
mm-hmm.
of hatred,
sure.
the burden of anger, because they came to Egypt. They didn't know that the prime minister was in charge
was
of food stock, was
yeah.
their brother.
Yeah.
And if you consider Genesis 47, you look at verse 5, The brothers are asking themselves. Maybe you could just read with us. 47 verse 5.
45 5 says, mm-hmm. Now therefore be not grieved, mm-hmm. nor angry with yourselves, mm-hmm. that you sold me hither. For God did send me before you to preserve life. Amen.
Now instead of Joseph being grieved that they sold him at a tender age, that through all those years he had gone through a lot, mm-hmm. to the point of finding himself in a cell, a prison, mm-hmm. one who was beloved of the father, one who had all the treasures of the home of Jacob. But right now, instead of taking them hostage because of their past, because he walks with God and knows that it is good to forgive, for God also forgave us, mm-hmm. he desires to tell that you should not be grieved. Take it on upon yourself that you did wrong. God had sent me earlier that I may pave way.
Wow.
So that makes sense to the book Romans 8:28, that all things work together for the good of them that love who? Love and fear the Lord, okay?
Amen.
So God works a way where there seems to be no way.
Mm-hmm.
He had gone beforehand in Egypt to prepare a replenishment for these people, the house of Jacob, the house of Israel, eh?
Mm-hmm.
So that when that time comes, it already foresaw what would happen. I love a writer who says that worry is blind and can never discern the future.
Wow.
Jesus Christ sees the end from the beginning.
Sure.
And he has got a thousand ways to provide for us, which we know not.
We know nothing.
So if Joseph did not have the kind of forgiving, the disposition to pardon, I don't think if his brothers would find it easy. They would have all been killed. Right?
Sure.
But now see that because forgiveness began with him.
Mm-hmm.
So forgiveness begins with an individual. Who is wrong? You accept that, okay, I could have also...
Who is wrong?
Who is wrong?
All right. That's interesting.
Who is wrong?
Uh-huh.
So that you make a step of making reconciliation.
All right.
Because those who wrong you, they might not wrong you. They might have wronged you without their notice.
Okay.
But now when you hold it in your heart, it is you who is hurting.
Yeah.
So if you accept that I'm wrong, and now I want to make peace with myself.
Yeah.
So you amend your ways beginning by yourself.
Sure, sure.
So that when you reach out to these people who have made you grieve,
mm-hmm.
you find it easy to say, it's all right, it happened, I've forgiven you.
Yeah.
And at that moment, you find that there's a solace, there's a comfort within you,
mm-hmm.
that you can never explain what has taken place. So it begins with the person who has been wronged.
Yeah.
The one who is offended.
Sure, sure.
Yeah.
Mm. So there's something interesting with Joseph. Joseph had this thing in him. He knew the God he served. And knowing that God sent his son, that's from John 3:16, that he should perish so that me and you should have eternal life. He overlooked our sins and sent his only son, who was in charge of heavenly treasures, of course, to come. Being sinless, he died to have me and you forgiven. That's simply what Joseph did. Joseph didn't look at the things that the brother did. He overlooked them. And so that he was able to help. You know, we have some people that will never forgive you because you did this and this, and they can count. So, does it mean when you forgive, you must forget?
You could forgive, but because of the carnal human nature, you might not be able to forget. But I want to believe Christ in us, the hope of glory, he will teach us and he will erase the bad memories if we submit all to him.
Amen.
Remember, Christ is sinless.
Uh-huh.
He comes to the world to save you and me.
Sure.
There's nothing wrong Christ has done. And when he came to his own rejected him.
Rejected him.
They never welcomed him. That's why the gospel went down to the Gentiles. It was taken away from the Hebrews and the Jews of that time.
Sure.
And when Christ has been betrayed and he has gone through hell, now he's on the cross. Instead of Christ cursing humanity, instead of him using his power to destroy humanity, he said that forgive them,
for they
know not what they are doing.
Wow.
I liken that to Stephen. He's stoned to death. But in that moment, God gives him a vision. And he sees Christ sitting in the throne. And he says that Christ, forgive them.
Yeah.
For they don't know. They don't know what they're doing. So it requires some primitivity or some primitiveness not to be able to view people as if they are in the right mind.
Sure.
So that you could see yourself as the only one who is right in this aspect.
Sure.
Then you follow them and have a conversation with them to sure. help them know where they went wrong.
Yeah, true. So friends, there's peace when you forgive.
Sure.
But it can only give you restlessness if you don't forgive.
Sure.
Because you'll be the one carrying a burden in your heart.
Mm.
And that's why we have people killing themselves, because they were not ready to forgive. But when you know that you need peace, then it's good to forgive.
Mm.
Yeah, for God in heaven has forgiven you and me. That's why he says in Isaiah 1:18, come, let's reason together. Though your sins are as red as
scarlet, I'll make them white
as snow.
Yeah, that means that as we bring it to an end, we'll be wrong.
Mm-hmm.
We could have gone through many things.
Sure.
But the process begins with us.
True.
For peace of mind and for reconciliation.
Sure.
To wait for somebody to come so that you could be forgiven.
Sure.
He says in Matthew 18 that if a brother wrongs you,
go to him. Yeah.
Seek for his attention and counsel.
Sure.
And as admonitions.
Mm-hmm.
If he refuses, pick a brother.
Yeah.
If he refuses beyond that,
go to the elders.
And to the elder, the child. If that has been done procedurally well,
leave it.
Then leave it with God.
Yeah.
So I wanted to add that you should also think for a friend
mm-hmm.
who you view as one who can keep your secret. And this friend is Jesus.
Sure.
You shouldn't be the first friend. So that when you look at those who are Christ-like, those who Christ is using, who are elderly, who can help you begin the process of what? I know that some people cannot forgive because it's a terror in their minds what mm-hmm. people have done to them.
Sure.
But even though I mean it's that, Christ is still saying that there is hope for everyone.
There is hope.
That we can forgive, we can make it right with us, mm-hmm. and we can make things work well. Together for us, we have the Lord.
Yeah.
And ultimately, peace shall be restored. There's only peace in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
As I finish now, in John 16, verse 33, says that Christ is telling the disciples that these things I told you beforehand, that in me you might find what?
Peace.
That in the world you shall face tribulation,
mm-hmm.
but be of good cheer, for I have done what? Overcome the world.
Amen.
You will only have peace when you learn to forgive.
Amen. So friends, we've learned about forgiveness. When you're told that you should forgive and forget, sometimes you may be hurt by someone and you have a scar. Of course, when you look at that scar, you remember what happened, but your reaction to that memory is what determines. So if you react to it negatively, you didn't forgive. But when you just look at it and say, oh, I let it go already, it's well with you, because you find peace. Because if you choose Christ, you find peace, you find rest, because he's the first, the last, and the best. So thank you for watching with us, and God bless you. So I don't know if you have something to add, or we can just pray.
I wish to say that
mm-hmm.
just learn to forgive. It might be so hard.
Mm-hmm.
Just learn to forgive.
Yeah. So all relationships, no matter which is it, maybe social, maybe family relationship, you need to forgive and pray.
All right. Fellow viewers, let's pray. Our Father and our God in heaven, we thank you for this fire you brought us. You've taught us how to forgive and what forgiveness is. We might not be able to understand it deeply, but I will pray that your Holy Spirit will revive in our hearts the desire to be able to forgive and to be forgiven also. Thank you for speaking to us. Continually bless us daily. We humbly pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.